Hello everyone, this is Mirzai, and in this lesson we're going to learn how to run a quadratic regression model in R. The first step to run our quadratic regression model is to bring the CSV file that includes the data into our R platform. So the very first line of code that I have here is just setting the work directory to the folder that I have my file saved. In your Blackboard, you have access to this file that is called Reynolds.csv. This is a dataset from the fourth chapter of the Essentials for Business Analytics textbook for this course. So I just ran the setwd command with the direction to the folder that includes my file. Now the next step for me is to read the CSV file. If you remember, the function for reading the CSV file was read.csv. And then inside this file, you should put the name of the file that you're trying to bring to this platform. Reynolds is the name of the file and it's .csv. If I just read it, it's not going to save it to any variable. So I'm going to create a variable called Reynolds that it's include the CSV file that we are reading here. So if I run this command line using Control Enter in Mac, or if you're using a PC, you can hit Control R to read this line of code in your console. So in the left-hand side, you can see my console as I implement the codes. And if there is any error or problem, I'll be able to see it in here. Now, the next step for me is to check and make sure that I brought everything correctly to the platform. So I run the hit function over the variable that includes my data right now. If I do that, you see that the first few lines is shown on my console and I have months since employment and scales sold. So this data set basically shows how much somebody sells based on the number of months that they have been employed in the company. So let's take a look at the scatter plot of this data. If you remember, plot would allow us to create the scatter plot. Now we have to show the X and Y axis here. So let's say your Y axis is scales sold and X is month employed. So I have to bring these variables exactly as they are. So I'm gonna copy this name here as exactly they are. So it's going to be month in employed versus scales sold. So now your R doesn't know that this column is related to this data set, Reynolds. If you run this line of code, you're going to get error because, let's try that. You see that there is error in reading this file because it doesn't identify these two are related to this data frame. So you either have to attach your data frame but prior to running this line of code, or you have to add the name of the data frame at the beginning with a dollar sign after that. So I'm going to use the dollar sign and avoid attaching my data set. Say Reynolds dollar sign month employed, Reynolds dollar sign scale sold. Now R knows that this column are related to this data frame. So if I run it this time, I'm going to be able to see my scatter plot. Now you see that this is the month of employment. As the month of employment increases, the scale sold increases, and at some point it has a downward trend here. And it kind of makes sense. You don't expect as the number of months that somebody has been employed in a company, their sales grows forever. If that was the case, then people that have been in the company for 40 or 30 years, they would have the highest sale, but that's not the case. So at some point, people get into some stability in terms of the number of items that they sell, and at some point it goes downward because maybe they lose motivation, or they lose the interest in the work, or the whatever reason that could be contributed to this. This is the trend that we see as the number of months employed increases. Now, how we can come up with a regression model to project this and explain this behavior? The best method for this one wouldn't be a linear model, because in a linear model, you're creating a straight line that goes through this. So it might give you a really good R-square, but if you use a quadratic model, it's going to give you a better R-square, which means that you're able to capture more of the variation and variability with a quadratic model as opposed to a linear model. So the first step to identify whether you need a linear model or quadratic model is a diagnosis test that you run over the scatter plot between your response variable and the variable that you hypothesize or have a feeling that it's going to have a quadratic behavior. Now, how can I implement that? There are multiple ways and packages in R that you can deal with this, but we can simply use the LM or linear model if we do a little bit of manipulation in our data, without actually going to sophisticated packages or functions. So basically, remember, in this case, now your models is going to look something like this. So you have beta 0 plus your month since employment multiplied by beta 1. So I would have put beta 1 prior to month. Plus beta 2 multiplied by month that is squared. So basically, you can run you can linearize this model by introducing a new variable for month squared. So basically, I can write it as this. So let's say z is equal to month squared. Now you can replace that z here in your model and say beta 0 plus beta 1 month plus beta 2 z, which is a linear model, with the difference that your z is actually a month squared value. So the way that we implement this R is first we have to create that a variable that is a squared. So I have to add a new column in my data set that represents that the month is squared. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new column. The way that you do it is using the Reynolds dollar sign. And whatever you want to call this new variable, let's say we call it Z because we already called it Z on the top. Reynolds Z is equal to your Reynolds month since employment, which is this variable. I just copy this exactly the same way it is. In Reynolds, column month employed squared of this column is going to be my Z, new column. So if I run this line of code and get the head function of Reynolds again, you see that Z has been added, which is basically the square of each of these month employed. You see 41, if you square that, you get 1681. If you square 106, you get this value, and so forth. Now I can simply run a linear regression model and see if this quadratic model has a good R-square or not. So this time, remember that your linear model function was LM, and then you have to put Y, the variable that you want to predict, which is the scales sold, and it's in the dataset Reynolds, so make sure you have Reynolds dollar signs scales sold as my Y, and my X, so you have a tilde here, and then you have to introduce your X's, or the variables that you have. One was Reynolds month employed, and the other one is Reynolds Z that we just introduced. And remember, one is month employed, and when we say Z is actually showing you the square of the month employed. And it's always a good practice to save this linear model into some sort of variable. I'm going to save it in a variable called output. And just run this line of code. Now, if I run output, it just shows me the coefficient of my regression model. But I don't know if both of these variables are significant and if my intercept is significant or not. I don't see the full-blown ANOVA table and t-table. To get the better understanding of this, if you remember, we had to run a function called summary. So summary of regression output, so I'm going to run summary of output. That way I'm going to be able to see the t-table and also the p-value for my test, and I'm able to make a more comprehensive analysis from what I just found. So if I look at the table, you see that all these p-values are less than 5%, and therefore you have a significant beta 0, beta 1, and beta 2. So basically your model shows that the month employed and the also the square of month employed are significant variables in your quadratic model. Now, also, you see that the p-value for the ANOVA table is highly significant. It means that it's very smaller than 0.05, so you have a regression model. Obviously, you could tell that by looking at this table as well. And the adjusted R-square in this case is around 88.5, which is a really good number for regression model. So it means that you were able to capture almost 88% of the variability in your data by using this line and using this line as a prediction of the future cells. So now, what is the final model that we have created? Remember, this was the initial model, beta 0 plus beta 1 multiplied by number of month employed plus beta 2 multiplied by the number of month employed that are squared. So my model in the end is going to be something like that. Y is equal to, according to this table, my intercept is 61.43, if you round it, and then you have plus 5.8 multiplied by month employed. I put month, and then you have minus 0.031 and multiply by month that are squared. So basically, if you want to know how much somebody's going to sell if they've been in the company for 10 months. You plug this 10 here and you have 10 square here, and then you calculate the amount of sales that they're going to provide for the organization. So this model basically tells you that if somebody's been hired, in average they're going to sell 61.43. But for every extra month that they have been hired, they're going to increase their sell for 5.8, and their sell is going to decrease by this amount multiplied by the number of months squared. So as you see, as the number of months that somebody has been hired increases, the amount of deduction starts increasing more and more, up to a certain point that the amount of reduction becomes more than amount of increase in their sell, and the plot starts moving downward. That's where the shift happens, and instead of growing in the sell, people start selling less and less because this negative term catch up with the positive terms, and it becomes even more. You start seeing the downward trend in your graph. With this, our lesson in running a quadratic regression model in R has concluded. Please refer to your blackboard for your assignments. Thank you.